can you be?
As the referee blows the final whistle, disappointment for the Australians.
And still now.
For Australia, Morales. That's it.
Eyes on the stars and your feet on the ground. Theodore Roosevelt's recipe for success has real resonance for Australia tonight, as they see a glittering prize twinkling on the horizon.
Just remarkable scenes. And remarkable noise.
They are ready, they are prepared, they're willing, they're determined to end 31 years of pain. The only question remains is whether they're good enough. Australia are chasing the tie. 1-0 down after the first leg of Montevideo.
Standing over that ball, it was on, you know, you can feel, you know, already now, I can feel the feeling that I had that night, because it was the biggest moment for all of us, but not just us, everyone that was in Australia.
Milano Raiola said this week Uruguay had a divine right to be at the World Cup finals. We're going to have to earn it this evening.
To suggest that they had the right to go to the World Cup, based on what?
If they think that we're going to roll over and give it to them on a plate, well, they've got another thing coming.
There it is, game underway.
We knew that they probably wanted to hit us early.
First free kick has gone Uruguay's way. Cola to deliver. Oh, and it bounced off Mark Schwarzer. He is the danger from any sort of range.
We knew how dangerous Rakoba was.
You kind of expect him to be the difference.
Lots of movements. Oh, and Schwarzer didn't get there.
And again, the ball was nothing short of world class.
Rakoba. Oh, he's nicked the ball away from Fidma. It's Rakoba! Oh. Could have scored, possibly should have scored.
You could almost hear the... Huh? Is this it? Is this the moment where our dreams are shattered again and it's going to go on for 36 years rather than 32? Fortunately, and again, fine margins, he put it the wrong side of the post.
That moment there, you think, well, maybe it's meant to be.
Australia have got out of jail there, Craig.
The Hus was great at delegating. He'd say, so give me the team. I actually put Popper out and brought Simi Cahill in. After about 10 minutes looking, he said, no, we start Kuhl on the bench. I went, my God. And he said, give out the bibs to the starting lineup. And I'm thinking, oh, no, that means I don't give one to Harry. And he said, and don't tell him, don't say a word to him. And Harry put his hand out for it, and I didn't give it to him. I kept walking past. You see Harry's face, and I thought, oh. And Couscous said, don't say anything to him. And he said, and he's going to take us to the World Cup. Trust me.
Ooh, and that was an arm across the face by Tony Popovic. Popovic is going to get a yellow card for that.
When Popper did the elbow, hitting was, that was his experience. Straight away he said, Harry, straight away, on, now, on. And hitting was just worried about Rakoba getting the ball, running straight at Popovic, doing a step over, foul, bang, second yellow, World Cup over, campaign over. But it was like, get him off now. Get him off.
Australia are going to make an early substitute.
Gus Hiddink has seen something he either doesn't like from Australia or that he wants to capitalise on.
At the time when it happens, when you come off as a player, you're disappointed because you want to stay out there. But you know, when you sit down and you cool down, you realise it's all for the one goal.
Harry came on and was fantastic that night. It was Hiddink sat there with a smile on his face. It was like he's gone out there to show me.
here's Kuhl. His first touch, super field. Finding Cahill. Looking tight the spaces. Here's Harry Kuhl. Fist hit. And it's in.
Still there.
Australia have scored. Marco Bresciano.
Yeah, to me, to be that person, it's obviously it's probably one of my most memorable nights in my career. But you know, I still feel it was just that bond we had, that team spirit we had that put us you know, over the line.
When that ball hit the back of the net, and I remember it rocketed up into the top of the goal, what a feeling.
Yes! They've scored! Yes! Yes! It's a magnificent goal to Australia!
Australia are level. What a moment!
I'm still chasing after it, like, you know, you're still a kid in a park trying to just help the ball in the goal, and Bresh swings his leg at it. And wow, and I'll never forget that celebration.
I didn't have time to do my celebration, they're already all over me.
Dream goal for Australia.
We changed the whole perspective of the match. You could see the boys really lift after that, and you know, the whole stadium lifted, got behind the players, and she changed the way they approached it.
It's Rakoba. Schwartz watched it all the way.
It's two free kicks now, Rakoba's wasted.
45 minutes to go. Australia resolve a headache that has plagued every football fan in this country for the last 31 years. Stay this way, and we would have extra time, conceivably penalties. I'm sure any of our hearts could stand that stress. Kobe's delivery, all free header, and over the top by Morales.
Guys, happen.
Uruguay can make their change, and it's as you suspected, Craig.
Rakoba has left the field for Marcelo Zalaeta. And that is an amazing decision.
A bit of genius has gone as well.
I wanted to beat him in those 90 minutes. I wanted to score that second goal just to have shown that we were the better team in 90 minutes.
Cristiano's wide left. Cahill with a header.
We're going to have one player arriving in the box for a ball on his head. He's probably the one.
Probably one of the biggest moments for me as a player was the presence of Gus. There's a presence that comes with him that does put a bit of fear into the opposition. And people say, well, he's just, it's not, it's the name, it's the changes that he can make, it's the tactical decisions. But also when he was talking to us, very calm, cool, collected man, but we knew this is it.
I said to him after the game, I said, you weren't even nervous, you don't. He says, you think so? He said, you don't know what's going on inside. He said, I have to look like it. And there was one time during the game, the camera went on Gus on the big screen, and I was standing up next to him, and I was chewing gum, like, and he leaned over and says, spit your gum out, you look like Mr. Ed. During the game, I'm thinking, after, how could he be like that? We're the biggest game ever.
82,000 voices in unison getting them over the line.
The gap for Montero now. Harry Kuhl in round the back. Kuhl shot. Well, there it is. The final whistle. Australia have won on the night by a goal to nil, but it's all square on aggregate. So we're going to be extra time.
Australia have dominated plenty of games in world football. Copped a sucker punch.
We've seen that the mental factor just become too much for them. Right now, they are the ones with the springs in their step.
I actually wasn't tired. So I felt probably I could go another 90 minutes. You just looked around at the players on the field and you knew something was going to happen. Something special was about to happen that night. And, we all wanted to be a part of it.
It's about belief in the shirt, belief in what you're trying to achieve. To me, it looks as though this bunch of players have got it.
Yeah, we were definitely anxious. We wanted to finish the game before penalties, most definitely. And I remember Goose making a couple more changes, getting some fresh legs on,
changing the team dynamic. We were pressing. As the game won, we pressed a little bit more because we knew we were fitter. We could outlast these guys, but they defended well.
Free kick's taken quickly, Varela. Now, Varela. Oh, just flies past the post. And he up from the back. It's a deep one towards Aloisi. On the volley.
What was it? Maybe 10 minutes or so before the end of extra time, I remember seeing out of the corner of my eye Zocco warming up on the sideline with Tony Franken and thinking, that's just odd, what's going on? And trying to work out how had we made all the substitutions yet, and realizing we hadn't, and I just thought, is he going to do what I think he's going to do? And then just trying to stay focused on the game, but still also corner of my eye, always being distracted by it.
If Edmonton didn't come off with the cramps, I think 99% it was going to happen.
Emo coming off with cramp? What the hell? That doesn't happen. You know, he's like a robot.
Thankfully, it didn't happen, and thankfully, I can think about what did happen and have played my part.
Looks like the dreaded shootout.
That's it,
and it's going to penalty. To decide who goes to Germany 2006.
Always have to do it the hard way, but after 31 years of heartache, perhaps this is the way it should be.
If they don't do it tonight, it will be a travesty.
How many times have we said that?
For 90 minutes of extra time was drama. We ain't seen nothing yet, folks. First penalty, Australia.
Beautiful.
Beautifully put away by Harry Kuehl.
Sheer class, Harry.
Thought we're playing a South American opponent. All these things are going through my mind thinking, well, they're going to be waiting for me to make a first move. And I thought, well, let me try and stay on my feet and let's try and push a little bit more pressure on them by making them make the first move.
Rodriguez against Mark Schwarzer.
I didn't make the first move, and all of a sudden they were left with a dilemma, you know, to try and put the ball past me.
It's a massive save. It's huge.
It's Neil. It's 2-0. Australia 2-0 up with the shooter. It's Varela. It's just on the mid short.
That was too good.
It was probably a few minutes before the end of the game that I reckon the emotion started to pour out. I think probably looking around and saying, well, this has probably been the last time that I'll play for Australia.
I'd never seen him take a penalty in his life. And I said to him, Spike, you want to take a penalty? He said, mate, redemption. It's my time.
It's a bit long.
Hey, what's he doing taking with his opposite foot? I didn't even know he was left-footed. Bloody hell, let alone right-footed.
Tony Dickmarsh, the hero tonight. Bresciano finished the goal. Tony Dickmarsh been a colossus.
Here we go. Beautifully tucked away by Stoyanov.
Yep, must get this one.
Can he hold his nerve, the Australian captain? What a stage. The number 9.
He's played the captain's role. Paduka. Graham Arnold can't look. Paduka. Oh, he's put it wide. Would you believe it?
If you speak to Dukes, he did exactly the same penalty the day before. Exactly the same. Same run up. Missed it just by the same amount. Exactly the same.
Well, I was lucky because Zalaieta played with me at Perugia. Basically, I said to him, Zalaieta shoots every single time to your left. Every time. He opens up and hits it to his left. Every time.
The ball was on the spot. Here is Zalaieta. Oh, great save again by Schwarzer.
Huge save.
Wonderful save.
Schwarzer saves again.
I look at the most significant saves, the most important saves that I've made in my career, and apart from probably the Canada saves, it would have to be the two saves against Uruguay.
It's as big as we've ever seen in Australia. It's as big as we've ever seen under pressure.
As soon as Schwarzer saved his, I just felt a sense of relief because I knew that that was it. We're going to go to the World Cup.
Football in this country really relied on that one result. You know, we hadn't qualified for 32 years. I remember Mark Viduka when hitting first come in, he said, "Why us? You could have taken any other nation, and you know, we haven't qualified for anything." And hitting said, "Because you're ready."
I defy anyone to say they've been at anything better this year. AFL Grand Finals, Maccabi Divas hat trick, you name it. They can't top this.
It was the first time the sport got the credit that it's deserved. And you see the impact that it made. Australia stopped from that one moment, but it also turned around and paid respect to a game that never was really respected in the first place.